moving on to the first topic, that is COVID-19. The Sambandhichi, I need not mention that so far we've been doing an extremely good job. In fact, 32 rounds of house-to-house survey jarigindi. Iroju, as we speak, we're conducting 32nd round of house-to-house survey. సో దీనికి సంబంధించి మీ అందరికీ కూడా తెలిసిన విషయమే, దర్ ఇస్ ఎ న్యూ వేరియంట్ వి స్పీక్ అబౌట్, దర్ ఇస్ బీయింగ్ రీసెంట్లీ స్పోకన్ అబౌట్, డిఫరెంట్ నేమ్స్ పీపుల్ ఆర్ గివింగ్ ఇట్, బట్ వాట్ ఎవర్ దట్ ఇస్, ఒమైక్రాన్ ఆర్ ఒమిక్రాన్, వాట్ ఎవర్ దట్ ఇస్, దట్ ఇస్ ఎ న్యూ వేరియంట్ దట్ ఇస్ సీయింగ్ ద లైట్ ఆఫ్ ది డే, విచ్ రిక్వైర్స్ లిటిల్ బిట్ ఆఫ్ కాషన్ because of its ability to percolate at a faster pace than any other variant. So ee background lo malli koncham guarded ga undalsina avasaramu guarded ga undalsina paristhiti koncham is required. Jagratalu teeskovalanu andaru kani kani jagratalu kuda daichesi teeskovalsinduga all the collectors are requested. Our tracking and tracing of these people, especially foreign returnees, that is very, very important. Please make sure that every foreign returnee is monitored. They've got to, you should leave no stone unturned in ensuring that these people are properly monitored. You would have to know where they are. You would have to know how they are doing. You just cannot afford to just let them loose, which could actually result into another pandemic. So please make sure that every foreign returnee is closely monitored. 15.60 lakh houses construction anedi jarugutha undi. The 15.60 lakh houses what have been initiated in the first phase for పేదలందరికీ ఇల్లు నవరత్నాలు కార్యక్రమంలో, దీంట్లో ద నెంబర్ ఆఫ్ హౌసెస్ దట్ హవ్ బీన్ గ్రౌండెడ్ ఆర్ 10.72 ల్యాక్ హౌసెస్, క్లోజ్ టు 70%. సో ఇట్స్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ దట్ దీస్ ద రిమైనింగ్ హౌసెస్ ఆర్ గ్రౌండెడ్ అట్ ది ఎర్లియస్ట్. ఇట్స్ వెరీ ఇంపార్టెంట్ దట్ these houses that are yet to be started, yet to be grounded, are revisited by the collector and identify the reasons as to why they have not been grounded as yet, and apply your mind and energy and focus into this particular area and make sure that every house that is being sanctioned is grounded. So this is one very, very important aspect. All grounding activities, the target set forth would be 31st January 2022. So 31st January kalla all the houses need to be grounded, all the sanctioned houses. The government is waiving off almost 10,000 crores of rupees. This is a huge amount. In fact, out of close to 15,000 crores of rupees, what actually are due, we are waiving off 10,000 crores of that money and facilitating this OTS. This would give them freehold title, meaning they would have the right, they would have the title to sell the property if they want the very next day, or gift it to somebody the very next day, or even pledge this property in a bank for any of their individual purposes the very next day. Scheme is a waiver of registration fee. In fact, the house and the property put together, in many cases, average is ranging from 5 lakhs to 10 lakhs. So it's very important that as proper awareness is created and properly it is spoken about. In fact, the people who are critical about this scheme might comment so many things. The worst part is, why didn't the previous governments not do it? Why didn't the previous governments not even waive, forget about the waiver of the amount of loan outstanding, but they never even bothered to waive the interest part. Forget about the outstanding loan part. These people who have not done even that, even it be these people who have not even done to that extent, are now commenting because they are anti-poor. They don't want this kind of rights over this property bestowed to the people, to the poor. That is the problem with these people. So this would have to be properly explained to every individual, and these people should be told about the benefits of the scheme. So far, the scheme has already started receiving good response. Jagannanna Smart Townships. This is also one aspect which is being developed for the welfare, for the good of the middle class, middle income group category, where we are actually developing these lands, wanting to give them litigation-free titles, wanting to develop this land with all the infrastructure facilities made available. So all the infrastructure facilities made available, litigation-free title also made available, the government stands guarantee, and the rate being at the least possible. So this would ensure that the middle income group category benefit hugely because of this scheme. Spandana grievances. Now, this is one aspect where until and unless collectors own it up, this program will not be a success. So basically, you know, somebody comes to us for some help. What is the mechanism that is in store? This is called Spandana. We christened it as Spandana. We want to make sure that this mechanism, what is in place, really serves the purpose. And for it to happen, until and unless the collectors own it up, until and unless you monitor the quality of redressal, I once again repeat this word, until and unless you monitor the quality of redressal, we will never be justifying ourselves. We will never be doing justice to our jobs. The reason why I'm saying this is there have been quite a few cases, quite a percentage, where we have cleared the case, yet there is a reapplication coming in. Fair enough. Here there are two aspects. One aspect is there should be quality redressal at the very first instance when you dispose of the case. That's the first thing that needs to be improved. The second thing that needs to be improved is when somebody reapplies, that means you have rejected the case previously, now it has come back for redressal once again as a reapplication. In those particular cases, how are you dealing with that? These are the two very important things that are very, very important for this program to be actually serving the purpose.